got to see the tape. I must see at the point where he entered the cage. I just absolutely am dumbfounded. And the King, who's been such a prominent part of not only all of professional wrestling, but of his hometown, Memphis, Tennessee, is having his hair shaved off in the center of the ring. Even more important to me, as I sit here and look at it, Lawler is hurt from that post shot that Idol and Rich put on him. Of being forced to cut the hair of an idol, and I don't mean Austin. Something that we never thought would be done, Lawler, having never lost a hair match, is having his head shaved in the middle of the ring with Rich and Idol, the culprits. Put it any way but the fact that this didn't just happen. This took some heavyweight planning for them to pull this on the King. As Rich continues to kick the referee outside the ring, Calhoun will be so sore tomorrow. Lawler has slumped down to the floor as the barber is continuing at the instructions of Idol to get it off. Congratulating each other, and Paul Dangerley, and Jerry's head is completely cut. The hair has all been cut down to a reporting calls for us to come to the dressing room of Austin Idol and Tommy Rich. Yeah, well, officially in a history-making match tonight, Jerry the King Lawler lost his hair to Austin Idol. It should read to Austin Idol and Tommy Rich. Yeah, how do I like it? You ask it. I want to tell you what I think. I've seen a lot of wrestling. I've seen a lot of things done. That's the lowest thing I've ever seen done in my life. This guy, you've been planning this. You took care of everything. How did you end up getting in the ring? Yeah. What were you doing inside that cage?
You know, Lance Russell, excuse us.
Yeah.
You come in to talk, but we don't need you in here. You know, I told you, Jerry Lawler, it was going to get intense. Real, real intense. I'm hungry, boy. Paul Lee, businessman. Look at that hair. But what we're talking about, Jerry Lawler, it everything was your way. Austin Idol put to return all the money to the building, put his hair on the line. But the one thing you overlooked, you put a big 16, 20-foot cage, but you forgot to look under the ring. Or you forgot to look when Pat Tanaka got out of the cage. They don't know where I came from. Intense, Lawler. Now you're ashamed to show your face. He don't even show his face around me. What is that?
Don't they realize something, T.R.? Don't they realize, Paulie, that I was born in Las Vegas, Nevada, Jack? I grew up not on a baby bottle. I grew up spinning the roulette wheel. I grew up playing five-card stud. I grew up pulling slot handles. I'm a gambler from the day I was born, and I'll gamble to the day I die. And, Lawler, when I put my $50,000 in the bank, I put it right in the bank. There was no shucking, no driving anymore than that. 50 grand of my money, brother. You said it came from a plane crash. It came from blood, from sweat, from tears. But you remember one thing. In Las Vegas, they always got a hole card. Hello, hole card.
It's in the hole, baby.
You're my ace, Carla. You're my ace. My ace.
I love it. I love it. I love it.
The greatest of all time. The new kings. Rich, sexy, and mean, darling.
King of the fools, Jerry Lawler, the people of Memphis, and you too, Les Russell.
Okay. Let me tell you. You had the ace up your sleeve. You didn't do it fair. That's all. Okay. Let's finish it. That's enough.
Get out.